Hello.
I was supposed to film this on Monday. Now it's Friday, but it's been a week. And I have been away all days of the week almost. And when I gotten home, I've been so tired. I have been so tired that I have not even opened up my boxes that I have collected from the post office. So yeah, then you know I'm tired. And also, I have gotten a lot of things that I have ordered. I have gotten this week, so they will be in here. But it's so annoying because I've gotten everything from my Jeffree Star order except the bullet lipsticks, and they were the ones that were almost shipped first. But yeah, that was what I was going to say. I'm just going to check and see if that palette is in here, because I don't think it is. No, it's there. I can start by saying that I have these two. I have ordered from Revolution, of course, and you receive these for free. It's the Revolution Pro 4K highlighter palettes. They have, you know, in bronzers and blush as well, but they are white. And I have ordered, so I got both the rose gold and the gold, and I already have these, so I will be giving these away. And I'm starting with that. And then I have two of these. Let's see where the other one is. It's there. This is the Revolution and Pride, Spirit of Pride. And this one, I have pushed this. Is this the second one? I don't remember. No, I think this is yeah, this is probably the second one. But this came, you know, it has lifted up, so I have pressed it back. It's kind of a pressed glitter, so it worked okay to press it back. But yeah, the other one I'm going to show you was more smashed, because I don't think the formula is stable for travel. But the other one, let's see if you can see, but the green one is kind of smushed and everywhere, and also the purple, and yeah, the glittery shades were coming out, and I will be giving this away as well, but I'm not shipping it anywhere because I'm afraid it will break. But if someone wants it, I have some people I'm going to ask, so you don't have to ask for it. But yeah, oh no, why did I do that? Now I have glitter everywhere. But yeah, so I have two of these, but these are going to be not be in my collection. Only one of them. So yeah, okay. So I have this palette. I don't know in which order I'm starting, but let's do it like that. And when I ordered that palette, I also ordered the cream one, Pride Express Myself face paint. And it's, you know, creams that you can use for face paint. Revolution usually have very good makeup for, you know, this is more like you do art or Halloween makeup and such. And I really like the other ones they have, so I'm excited. It's green. Oh, by the way, I also have ordered from Swatch Perfect UK, the Pride collection and so on, but I will not be showing that. And I will not be showing, I never show you when I buy hair care or body lotions or shampoos. I have showed you perfume once, but I have gotten some new things of that, and I'm not going to show that. I will put in a video with the skincare that I have bought from Revolution, because I have that in the bathroom. I don't have any skincare, hair care, body care, or anything in my makeup room. I only have makeup in here. So I have filmed where I have it on the toilet in the bathroom, so you will see. But it's kind of, you know, all the face masks and all the serums and all the face sprays. Here are the masks I have bought because I don't want to take them inside. So I'm just going to film them. I have bought all of the face masks from Revolution.
that they have. And I also have, let's see, in here, let's see. That one. That one. This is so good. And that one. Boop, boop, boop. Like that. And I also have bought this. I have bought all of these things, sorry for it's dark, except for the Drops of Youth and the other things. So it's a lot of serums, and here are the mini versions, and there is a lot of face sprays. I don't feel like showing it one by one, because that will take a lot of time, so I'm showing you like this instead. Yeah.
But yeah, so I bought this as well. This is good. I can show you these because they're so awkward. Look at this. I finally got my Bombshell Cosmetica order. I will not get into that because it annoys me so much. But I ordered these palettes in the middle of April. And... yeah, I will not be ordering from them anytime soon. Unless they come out with something I really need to have. But then it really has to be good for me to order. But in this one, this is the Bomb Burger eyeshadow palette. In this one, you open it up like this. I saved this box because I think it's cool. And the palette was inside. I'm going to show you. Don't break it. And it looks like this. I don't like the packaging of these three palettes because you open it up like this. It's magnetic and I don't like it when there is no... I would rather have, you know, that it open up like this or something because I'm so afraid it will slide around even though it's a strong magnet. But yeah, this is the Bomb Burger palette and it looks nice. It's all mattes in here. Looks fine. We'll have to try it. I have two other palettes from them that I have liked, so. Yeah, and there's a big mirror in here. So it looks like that. Now we can put that back in here. Beep, 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 beep. I am not figured out how to store these yet, but I'm going to do some, what's that called? Redecorating. I have bought new furniture and I have to change some stuff to if they are going to fit in here. So I'm going to see if I can store these in some good way. Yep. And then I bought Fresh Baked. That looks like a, and they also smell, by the way, nice. This is the cookie one. Oh, it smells really nice. And there are 5 mattes and all the rest is shimmer. So it looks nice. Looks like they are really foiled. But I've not tried them, so I don't know. And it's the same design. And that's also annoying because you have to remember how they were put. Like that. So it looks like that. I'm sorry for my hair, by the way. And the last one is the coolest. It's the strawberry milkshake. Woohoo! So it looks like that. And I think these are all shimmers, right? And they are pastel shimmers. I'm really excited for this one. And they are really creamy. Ooh. Ooh. Look. Ooh. This one, I don't know what it smells like, but yeah. And this one is kind of, you know, if I push there, it will open. I don't like that. It's bent, but yeah, we'll put it like that. I should have taken off this. This is going to be a long video, just so you know. Then I ordered from, you know, Makeup Obsession, Love is Love. And I think it's 3 pressed glitters. It looks like that. Really pretty. Then I ordered 2 new chocolate palettes. And you know I will keep buying the chocolate palettes because I collect them and I think they are pretty. But these ones actually looked fun on the inside. And this is the Creme Brulee. So it's yellow, light yellow one with chocolate. And it looks like that. It's a yellow and a blue and some neutrals, but it's still pretty. And it doesn't smell very nice, to be honest. And then we have the sprinkles one. Woohoo! It looks like this. I get so happy when I see colors. I think all are kind of shimmers or satins at least. There are no pure mattes. This smells a little better. I love these. And then I found out this yesterday, I think, when I saw Paulina's video. What was it that she showed? Was it her haul? No, it was new makeup releases, right? It was new makeup releases. That's what it was. That these 2 palettes are dupes for the Pat McGrath palettes. I didn't know that. And I usually think I pick up on that. But then again, I'm not that into her brand because I have just bought my first palette from her, as you will see. But this is from Revolution Pro Night and Day palette, and it's called Color Focus, and it's so nice quality. It's a bit crooked, you know what I think about that, but it's so nice quality. And this one I will glue because the names are up here. Let's put it here. But it looks like this. So it's kind of baked shadows, and these looks so cool. And that one looks super matte, the black one. But yeah, I'm looking forward to try these. And now I will pause you so I can glue. Like that. And the other one is called Earth and Stone. And this one I like a little bit better. That is like a pink duochrome. It looks so cool. Looks really cool, and I always glue when there are names on the plastic, otherwise I just throw it away, but the names are on here, so I glued it. So they will be here for now while they dry. Then I have the Jeffree Star things, and it was so much fun because when I got the package from FedEx, I was so sure that it was the bullet lipsticks because they lip ammos. Oh, sorry, because they were shipped first, but then it was the palettes, and that I am more excited about. So they are so sturdy. This is not cheap cardboard. I love this type of cardboard, and I love the design of these things in this collection. This is the Mini Breaker. And it looks like that. I have swatched it because I showed my mom. And I think this is so pretty. And I really like the shade Orange Crush. That one. It has sparkles in it, but I don't know if that will show up. The only shade that I'm kind of is the Hot Fudge, which is a cool toned brown. I don't really get that, but you know, one shade I can live with, but it's so... Oh, and then we have, let's take that first, the big one, Jawbreaker, and it's also so sturdy and big. And this one looks like that. I think it's so pretty, and I'm not surprised that he released a rainbow palette. That shade Cotton Candy looks so nice. And it's so nice over here, because if you get color hair, you can easily take it away, because it's there are something on top of it that makes it go away easy. I don't know what it's called. Ooh, there are so many shades that look so pretty. But yeah, so this is Yawbreak. I wonder if that will fit into my place where I have these palettes. We'll see. And today I got the Brain Freeze palette. You know, I have said this many times and I'm so sorry, but I have the other two highlighter palettes, the 24 Karat and Platinum Eyes. You cannot compare the quality to those palettes to this one. This is so much sturdier, and when you open this up, I think these are bigger pans, right? I think these are, I don't know. But this looks so much more quality and nice than the other two I have. I'm so disappointed in the other two I have. Not in the quality of the highlighters, but in the quality of the packaging. It looks so cheap, it looks so fake. But this one looks so nice, and I swatched that one. Oh, it's so pretty. It's so cool. I'm really impressed. I'm really impressed by the quality of packaging. I have always liked Jeffree Star's packaging, except for those two palettes, but this one is a step up. Then I ordered, this, it's the Supreme Frost in Candy Apple Drip, because you know I want the funky colors. And it's a green, and it looks like there is like pink purple. I don't remember what he said, but it looks like that. I've swatched these, and they are so pretty. I will not be able to use this as, oh, when I put it in this angle, it's totally pink. God, that's cool. Let's see if I can show that in some way. I don't think I can. That's too bad. That's so cool. When I hold it like this, to me, it looks like a purple pink highlighter. Let's see if I can take a photo of it, if I remember. That's so cool. Oh, you can't see it. But yeah. I thought I was just going to buy those two. That was one. But then everyone was talking about the Diamond Wet, so I bought the other two. So I bought Diamond Wet, which is a super pretty peachy one, or champagne or whatever. It's so pretty. And then I bought the other one because I can't have all but one. And it's the Caramel Kiss. Obviously too dark for me as a highlighter, but I don't care. I don't care. I love the packaging of these. God, it will be so nice to be able to put this away. And then I got the liquid lipsticks. And I love the chartreuse color, by the way. These. So we have... But it's really hard to read because he has white text on a light green chartreuse color. So yeah. So this is Purple Urkel. And there are shimmer in this one. Pretty. Then we have... Is it called Fully Nude? God, I don't remember. But it's a nude with, is it pinky? I don't know, you know me, it colors peachy maybe. And then we have... Yes, ma'am! Super pink! And then we have... Strawberry Crush, I think. I'm so sorry if I'm saying a wrong name, because it's so hard to read. And then we have the... really strange color called No Offense, and I think this is pretty close to Venus Flytrap, even when he compared them, but yeah, it's really cool. And the last one is Bronze, is it called Bronze Blood? God, yeah. So these are the shades. Someone is writing to me. Yeah.
really pretty. Can I put these somewhere? Let's put them in here.
And then I bought two lipsticks from Body Shop, from their Christmas collection. I don't think I've seen them until now. There were three, but I bought two. Who am I? It's Champagne Dusk and Flaming Horizon. And these, I don't know if it will show up, but they are glittery lipsticks. I don't think it shows up, but they are really glittery because I saw the ones that were used. And these smell nice. And yeah. I really like the pattern. It's stars on it. Let's put them there as well. And now I have to drink again. I always forget where I put it. I will show you a lot of ColourPop here soon, but I've still not received my Blue Moon main squeeze and so on, but it's on its way. But yeah, I ordered because Paulina has raved about this foundation, so I bought it because it's cheap. It's the Ardell Camera. I was about to say camouflage, but it says camouflage. Is it called that? I don't know. High def foundation. The bottle feels really cheap because it's plastic, but you know, I've been on a foundation kick recently. I'll show you, but yeah. And I bought the lightest one. Let's see if I can use it without mixing it. But you know, it was like $10 or something from Beauty Bay. So I bought it and I will be excited to try it. I also bought this from Benefit, Hello Happy. And it's so fun because this looks so tiny, but I actually checked and there are equal amount of product in this one as was it in Born This Way, that was equal. Yeah, so you know, it's as much product in these bottles as it is in this, but this one is more travel friendly and I've used this 3 times and I love it so far. It's so nice to have now on summer. And I will buy this if not something happens and they will stop selling this. I will buy a backup to have with me when we go on a cruise next year because it's perfect to take with you. Yeah, and I will put that in here because that I'm using. So we got that away right away. Then I tried ColourPop's So Juicy Plumping Gloss. I'm not a gloss person per se. I love the ID, but I rarely use it. And I'm not a fan of tube glosses. But everyone's talking about this, so I bought one of these. And this one is called Partly Rowdy. And it's a shimmery one. I tried it before and it doesn't hurt, but it's like a minty feel. I don't know if I like it or not, but I'm getting more positive about it because it's not that annoying, but it's just that you feel it all the time. But it was a really big tube. I was not expecting that and it was a really pretty gloss, so I'm glad I bought it. And then this. I'm not a stick person. That sounds weird, but I hope you know what I mean. But I had to try this from ColourPop because everyone says that they are great. So I bought a highlighter stick and this one is called Flying High. And I must say this packaging is so fancy. It really feels fancy because the screw thing is so nice and easy. I'm just really impressed. But it's like a light purple holographic, what we call holographic thing. It really looks pretty. It's purple glitters in it. And it looks really nice. And I'm so, so impressed by the packaging that I'm actually considering buying more and a blush stick and so on because this feels nice. Let's put it there. And I bought 3 glitters that I thought looked unique to my collection. Loose glitters, and they look like this. So this is Ticket to Ride. It's just that the lid doesn't, I'm showing you, but there's a lid inside of this that keeps the glitter inside, and it's not that good at keeping the glitter inside, so I have glitter everywhere. But this is like a red orange, I think there are pink as well, and this was called Ticket to Ride. And then I bought Flying Squirrel, which is a neon pink with with gold, so pretty. And then the yellow one called Or Bust. Is it called Or Bust? I don't know. But you can see for yourself. It's so pretty. Where should I put this? Can I do like this? Has this dried now a bit? Maybe? And then I bought 2 packs of glitters that are in these pots. See if I can remember which were with which. I think that one and that one. I think they were in these 2 collections, but they only have 2 collections, so it's not that hard. But they look like this. See if you can see. They are. Some of these, they are glitter gels, you can say. And this one is like a silvery one. It's called Star Party. In some of these are just glitters. Some of there are big glitter particles, and some are stars and so on. But I have some big ones, but I thought it would be nice with small ones. Then I have Starfire, it looks like a light pink one. I hope I don't have these already. And Keep It Platonic, looks like a white. Then they had a pack where one of the ones I have wanted for a really long time was in. And it's the Hopeless Romantic. See if I can open it, you can see. It looks like that. And there are really big chunks in here. I don't know if you can see, but it's really nice anyway. Oh, now I have glitter everywhere. Why do I swatch glitter? Oh, I have it everywhere. Stupid. Yeah. And then I bought Disco Lady and Bring the Heat. And it's a gold and what's the difference? Where is it? And this one has more bigger chunks in it than this one. But yeah, so I bought 6 of these. And I bought, I don't know why ColourPop sells this, but I thought it was so fun. I bought this pin there, done that, and it's, you know, you slide it open and there are, you call it bobby pins, right? And I thought it was cute, so I bought it. Then, when I bought the foundation from Ardell, I bought 2 more things from Beauty Bay that were on sale. I bought the Melt Stack Blueprint, it was on sale. I really, really hate that I don't have the blue one, but, you know, I'm just going to keep it in my palette, so it doesn't matter really, but yeah. So it looks like that. Let's see if I can show you. The blue shades are so pretty, but yeah. So that is 2 of the shades, and then we have those 2. Looks really nice. And then we have the 2 boring shades, but these actually look more pretty than they do on the website. Oh, that's a pinky peach gold. I love that. And then we have, yeah, these 2 are boring. So those are the shades in the blueprint stack, or does it say that this is the, before they always said that it belonged to which stack, but they haven't done that for the latest two, and it feels a lot different. I don't know, but yeah, I bought it. Really want the other one as well. Then I bought the UVS Place the Heroin Glow 2. I don't mind this packaging, but yeah. And it's a really pretty highlighter. It's peach. Peachy pinky. It's so pretty. This cost also $10. So yeah, and I really love the print on these. Then I bought two Becca highlights that I have been looking for, not looking for, but I wanted to buy them for a very long time, and I think I kind of collect the Becca highlights, but it's also one of my favorite formulas. So I bought the Year of the Pig. It looks like this. It's with the gold on the side, and I've used it and I've liked it. It looks like that. It's more like a peachy champagne. And then we have the one everyone hates, Ocean Glow. It's the Australian one in the Passport series. I can tell you, these two shades are so damn pretty. So yeah, it also annoys me that you have the brown, because it's really hard to use. But you can easily use these two with a brush, and they are so pretty. I wish they had these separate, because they are so pretty. But yeah, you can't have everything. Maybe, wait. Maybe I can put them back right away and save some time. Now I can't buy more Becca because I don't have any room. Then I bought something that I hate the packaging already, but they didn't have any other packaging, so I had to take the white one. But it's getting dirty, I don't like it. But I bought from Lethal Cosmetics. And usually when, because you pick out your singles that you want, please, if you buy from Lethal Cosmetics, go into the eyes category and then scroll down to the bottom and then pick Make Your Palette, because that then you'll get 30% off. Compared to if you would have picked out the shades yourself and put in a palette, just so you know. But usually when I pick out shades for a custom palette like this, I just take all the shades I want, and I don't care if they go very well together or if it's just shimmers or whatever. But when I have picked out 16 shades, which was really hard because there were a lot of shades that I wanted, I realized that all of the shades go very well together except for one, so I changed that, so I had a theme. So mine looks like this. It's green and blue, kind of. And there are 5 mattes, I think, and 7 shimmers, and you know, duochrome and so on. And I have not used it on my eyes, but I have swatched both the mattes and the shimmers, and they feel so nice and good quality. And I love, because under the mirror it says objects in mirror are braver than they appear. It says over there. So I'm really looking forward to using it. And it's so, you know, when you get these, they are each in a pan or a box or whatever you're going to call it, with a magnet. That must be so expensive to make, but yeah, I don't know. That was all in the front. Now let's take it in the back here. Let's take some stuff out. I have bought 2 lip glosses from Jeffree Star. I love the design. I actually want the concealer just for, you know, I never use concealer like that, but I want the packaging. And I bought Ice Cold because I thought that looked so cool. I have showed this in some of my videos, but it's really cool shade. And then I thought I wanted something different, so I bought her Glossiness, which is a pretty brown. I have just used these on their own and they looked really nice, so I guess they look fine when you put them on top of something else. Then I bought from Revolution their new micro brow pen in light brown, which is the lightest one they have. And it's, you know, I don't know if you can see, but it's, I don't think you can, but it's, you know, so there are zigzag, or what you're gonna call it. So there are three things sticking out, so you can do, you know, the light, so it looks like hairs. I don't know if it shows. I'm so bad at explaining. Let's see if I can focus. No, I hope you understand what I mean. Can you see there that there are kind of like that? It looks really nice, and it was really hard to take off, so I hope it works fine. And then I bought a primer from Revolution Pro Hydra Matte Primer. I have a hard time grasping how it can be Hydra Matte, but it's supposed to moisturize and still keep you matte. And it's in a glass bottle with a pump. It feels really expensive. Let's take these. And I also bought the powder in the new collection, but I must say that this packaging feels really cheap compared to the other things in the collection. It feels really luxurious. I have a hard time saying that, but this feels really cheap and flimsy. But it's a translucent powder, new neutral translucent pressed powder, and if you flip it, there is this. Really feels nice though. So I'm a bit disappointed in the packaging, but yeah, whatever. And then I bought, also because of Paulina, the bronzer Reloaded in Holiday Romance, the baked one. They usually have good bronzers, so yeah, I bought that one. Then I bought the two new heart things. I bought the Pride one, Love. Looks like that. So cool. I like these. And then I bought the Inspired by Love, and it's a collaboration with, I don't know, it's spelled the same way. I do not know this organization, but Marie Curie. Marie Curie. I can't pronounce it, but it Curie. You know, the same name as the scientist woman. Yeah. But there's a foundation that's called that, and yeah, it supports that cause anyway. And I thought that was a nice thing, and I also want these. They don't smell in a special way, but yeah. Then I bought these I've had in here for the longest time. But I bought the three neon palettes from Huda Beauty. I love the packaging. It's not cardboard like the others, it's plastic, but still. I have used the pink one. I think this is just called, they don't have the names on it. Then I have to put that on it. That I hate. But I think this is called the pink neon one. And it's really good. I used that in my, you know, in the big Pride collab. Really nice shimmers, really nice. I'm just checking. Shimmers and mattes. Really like it. And they are really neon, some of these shades. And I think it's a good color story. Then we have the orange one. And here are some pinks and purples and green. Oh, two of these shades should be in the other one, but yeah. So it looks like that. I really like this as well, and I think it's okay considering the outer packaging. But then this, I don't understand this. This is the green obsession, it's called, right? And there are not a lot of greens in this. There are pretty shades, don't get me wrong. They are really pretty, but they have nothing to do with the packaging. These three, and I just put my finger in. Have a lot to do with the packaging. The other ones, I'm like, what? And like I said, they are really pretty, but I don't understand it, you know. And what I also used in the Pride collab is the Morphe, is it called 25L Live in Color. And I really like the shades I used. It's so pretty. And I usually like the Morphe palette, so. Really pretty. A lot of mattes in here, but also some shimmers. Yeah. Hey, Gumball. Hey. Okay. Then I bought my first Pat McGrath palette. It's on this. This is one of the smaller ones, and they had free shipping to Sweden. Let's see. And I like that you could pay the customs in advance. But yeah, you open it up like this. Oh, this I'm also going to glue. Get out. But it looks like this. Vad ska du? And the shades I have swatched looked really nice. And this is the color scheme that looked most fun to me. And it must be like that. Now I'm going to glue this so you can hang on. So yeah, so that's what that looks like. And I'm so excited to use that. Okay, let's start over here. I have two more palettes from Bombshell Cosmetica that I ordered. It's the Sour Blast eyeshadow palette, and it looks like this. Really like it. When I see this, I think of the Lime Crown one. It's not the same shades, but I just think of that. The 10th anniversary one. This smells nice. It smells like candy. But yeah. And then we have the Oh Hubba Hubba. Nah. It's more like a pastel-y one. Pastel-y. So they look like that. So I look forward to using this. It's so pale green and, you know, oh, I'm so bad, but like, oh, we say smutsrosa in Swedish, like a dirty pink. I like it. So I bought these two. Sluta peep! Then I bought the three animal print one from Revolution. Really nice packaging, I must say. They are called the Wild Animal Palettes. And this is the Courage. And they look really nice quality, but I have not tried them. This is Courage. Really looks nice, I must say. Really like the packaging. And then we have Fierce. It's the more warm toned one. But it looks really pretty. It's almost neon in some ways. And I like that type of warm tone. And the ones with the print are the matte ones. And then the one that is the coolest. And it's the Integrity. See, it's blue print over here. And you know. Look at this. I can't see myself. Yeah, I think it looks pretty. It's just, it's not a normal rainbow palette. I think there are some more shades in here. I really hope this is good quality. But it feels like that. And then I bought one that everyone says is the dupe for the Huda New Nudes palette. I don't have that one. I've looked at it and it looks really pretty. But yeah. Oh god, this is so dirty. But apparently, Paulina said that Huda duped Beauty Creations palette, so you know. But this is the new Neutral Luxe Shadow palette. It looks like that. Like that. And it's really similar when I have looked at... Sorry that... Can you please focus? And there is actually a cream shade here, just like the Huda one. That can't be a coincidence. So, and these are pressed glitters, and there are some shades that look like her, you know, shades, but yeah, but there are glitter everywhere. Glitter. Yeah. Oh god, now I have glitter everywhere. Stop touching the glitter shades! Then I bought the Roxy Roxoros Color Burst palette. The colorful one. I actually thought it looked really nice. I like these shades here. I think it looks really nice. And it's so flashy. And then I bought the Vintage Lace Blush palette. I'm almost done now, people. And I have the highlighter one, and that was an overspray. So I'm suspecting that there is an overspray in this as well. But they are still pretty. So yeah. Then I bought the new Carmi palette, Make Magic. This is such a pretty packaging, by the way. But yeah, this looks like this. These shades are so cool. I have swatched two of them. So cool. Then we have Anastasia Beverly Hills Alyssa Edwards palette. Oh, and let's take out the brush. Because that I don't want inside here. And you all probably know what this looks like. Like that. I have to use this in the Riviera palette. But I like this packaging, actually. That Beyond shade looks really nice. Yeah. And then this one I am so excited to use. It's the Jouer Tan Lines. I think this looks so pretty. Especially, of course, here. But I actually think these looks pretty nice as well. But these four. Yeah, I'm really excited. I think it's a really pretty palette. Then I finally got the Ace Beauté Flare palette. But it took forever to get to Beauty Bay. So I guess the Oceanic palette will take forever as well. But this is so pretty. I'm so excited to have it. Look at that mustard. Ooh. I think it looks so pretty. And the last two are glitter palettes. I have the other two, so I bought this. This is holographic. I don't know if it shows up. It looks silver here, but it is actually holographic because there are all colors. And this is the Illusion one, I think. Ooh. It looks like that. Pressed glitters from Revolution. And then this one is called the Diva, I think. It's baby pink. It looks like that. I don't like this packaging. It's not, you know, glitters are not coming off, but it's... fan heter streift. There are texture here that I don't like. Was that all? I think so. It's empty. Yay! I think that was all. And under 1 hour. Okay, but I would cut in something, but I would cut out as well, so it will be fine. I think I have put everything here. Oh, that should not be there. I think so. Yeah. And there are still stuff coming in that I have ordered in June and May for that matter, but yeah, that was all people for this haul. Bye.